Hi guys, once again welcome to TechnoBeast. Friends, in the continuation of our discussion on various software development lifecycle models, in today's lecture we are going to talk about a very popular and largely used SDLC model, that is V model. But before starting to learn about V model, we'll first discuss the verification and validation, which consists in fish model. So before going further, if you have not subscribed my channel yet, do subscribe it for future updates. Like and share my videos amongst your friends if you have find my content useful, and do let me know your queries and feedback in the comment section.
This is the diagram of fish model. This is the advanced version of fish model. Okay, so fish model consists of two main parts, that is of verification and validation. So here we are going to see the phases which will be working in fish kind of model. Here there is a first phase is of requirement gathering, in which BRS document will get documented. After that, second phase is of analysis, and in analysis phase the SRS document will get prepared. After analysis, there is a design phase. After designing, there is a coding phase. And after coding, there is a testing phase. And lastly, there is a maintenance is done. So, from first phase to the coding, that part we called it as a verification. And from coding to the maintenance, that part we called it as a validations. In every phase, there is a review process. That review process, we also called it as verification. Also, the another name of verification process is of static testing. Then, we also called it as a quality assurance. In verification, we also check the quality assurance of the product. Now, moving towards the validation part, in which we also called it as a dynamic testing. Here in validation, we also check the quality control. In the part of verification and the validation, we are going to check the quality assurance in verification and quality control in validations. This is a diagram which is look like a fish, and it will be working in a fish type. Means after completing the coding process, here the testing part will be done. But in testing part, the validations will be happen. Okay, so we are going to see one by one in details. In first part, we are going to see the verification, how it works, right? After that, in validations, we are going to see how we are going to check the dynamic testing and the quality control of the product. So this is all about the diagram of fish model. Now we are going to move in towards the detail about the verification. Now we are going to start the verification part. As we are going to see the fish model, in this fish model there are two parts in which the testing process is done. In this, the first part is of verification part, right? And in second part, there is of validations. So these are two testing types which will be used in fish model, or we are going to use in V model. On the basis of this two types, verification and validation, V model is also working. Okay, so from these two, verification and validation, we are going to see the first part is of verification. So this is nothing but the advancement of the SDLC model, in which verification process is also called as quality assurance. Means here The another name of verification is nothing but the quality assurance, right? Then it is also called it as a another name of this verification is also a static testing. Another name is of static testing, or we can say that documentation testing. The name itself describes its working, right? In these fish model, the verification part, that is of, there are some phases will working under the verification part. So in this, the requirement gathering process, analyst will gather all the information from customer and make the BRS document, right? Business requirement specification document will get prepared by the business analyst in this requirement gathering phase. Then from this BRS document, BA will make the another document, that is of SRS document. With the help of this BRS document, SRS document will get prepared by this business analyst, right? So with the help of this SRS document, or we can say that SRS document involves total functionality of the project. Means in this SRS, total functionality of the project will get involved, right? So the BA have to check whether it is correct or not. BA will get check whether it is correct or not, right? So why it will get checking all this process by this BA person? Because all further process are depend on this SRS document, because this SRS contain total functionality of the project. That's why they have to check whether all the functionalities will get correctly working or not, right? After that, this checking process, we called it as a review process. That process we called it as a review process. Okay, then the design phase after completion, means design phase will get come in picture and it will doing that their work, right? After completion of this design phase, the architecture and pre-architectural plan, right? All this plan will be happen inside the design phase. Okay, so again in that design phase, you have to do the review process. Means in each phase, you have to follow the review process, right? Because the verification is done in first phase to the up to the coding phase. In review phase, there is requirement gathering phase, right? After that, there is of design phase. After that, there is of coding phase. So in all these phases, you have to follow this review process. After coding is over, coder have to check all the code and he have to compile code, find errors and fix the errors. This process is also called as a unit testing or code level testing. Whatever the coding functionality will get checked or the functions will get checked, in these there is happen testing, and that testing we called it as a unit testing, or we can say that it is a code level testing. Okay, so in the static testing process, responsible authority do only positive checking or review. Means we can say that it is nothing but a verification testing, right? Or we can say that it is nothing but a static testing. So in these, they only check the positive scenarios, right? Or review process will get happen, right? So, this is nothing but a static testing in which there is no tester and developer is involved and no coding is there in the static testing. Okay. Verification focuses on find defect as early as possible. Means it focused on find defects as early as possible. Means here the software application need to confirm the predefined requirement specification. As the software development goes through the different phases, it is necessary to ensure that deliverable of each phase is as per the specification. Means here predefined requirement specification are need, right? For what? To confirm that all the deliverable of each phase is as per these requirement specification or not. Means with the help of this predefined requirement specification, we are going to check whether the deliverables of each phase are as per the requirements or as per the specification, right? So the verification makes sure that software application is getting developed in correct way with respect to the requirements. Means here in the verification they are working on, are we doing the job right? Verification working on, are we doing the job right? Means for checking whether the each phase of working in a correct way or not, right? Now we are going to see the process of the verification, right? So in this process, during the verification, content of SDLC deliverable including code also called as work product. In this process there is a code and that code we called it as a work product. That code we called it as a work product. Okay. So are read and review by one or more responsible team members to find defect in them. Right? So this code and product word will get read and review. Will get read and review by the one or more persons which is included in a team. Okay. So this process have two methods. Verification process have two methods in which the first method is of walkthrough method. First process is of walkthrough method and the second process is of review method. With the help of this method, this verification process is happening. Okay, so the following are the different document deliverables of which verification activity is conducted and defects are reported. Documents are need to then revise to take care of the reported defects. Means whatever the process will get reviewed by the persons that will be take care for the to find out the report to find out the defects in that report will get reported. Okay, so in which document of understanding software requirement specification, the first will get required, that is of documentation of software requirement specification. Software requirement specification is required, right? Then high level design document, right? High level design document is required. After that, detailed design document is required, and finally the code is required to check or to review the verification process. Means in this verification process, the different document deliverables are required for this verification activity, and it will be conducted to find out the defects, and that defects are reported, right? So in which the 4 points will get required, that is of for understanding the software requirement specification, after that high level design documents and detailed design documents, after that code will get required.
I hope you understand today's topic well and hope you guys enjoyed it a lot. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe for this video. Thank you.